समस्त वैष्णव वैष्णव बिंद मातृबिंद गोकुल सज्जन बिंद हरिकथा पिपासु सत्यबिंद परम स्नेहशिला मातृबिंद
So the affectionate mothers to everyone. Please accept Madan Davat Pranams accordingly. So until now, you have you've heard Harikatha from the Brahmacharis and from others. They spoke beautiful katha. Actually, whatever we get in this world is by mercy of Guru Pada Padma. Only the mercy of Guru can save us. Without the mercy of Gurudeva, we cannot get anything in this world. Prahlad Maharaj told his friends from Gurukul in the school. He told, we can get everything by the service of Guru. Those who have really served the Guru, those who have love and affection for the Guru, serving Him with love and affection, these people, they're able to realize spiritual things. Why? For realizing spiritual things, you cannot realize spiritual things by knowledge and just erudition and like this. In the Upanishads we see that to know the transcendental things, to know God, there's only one way. When you get the mercy of Guru, the mercy of Bhagavan. Cannot attain to Him just by giving lectures, like, oh, I'm a great conference speaker, I speak so well. By this kind of egos, you cannot get God, attain to God. Or only by studying the Veda, Puranas, and Upanishads. To know Him, there's only one way. Which one? Serve the Guru. By the mercy of Guru, then all these tattvas will manifest in our hearts. In the Guru Astakam, Śrīla Viṣṇu Chakravarti, he told. If you get His mercy, the mercy of Guru, you get the mercy of Bhagavan. Without His mercy, you can never get the mercy of Bhagavan. This Guru Pāda Padma. Every time, every day, three times a day, we pray to the feet of Gurudeva. Three times a day. Means early in the morning, lunchtime, and evening time, also Sandhya, the sunset time, twilight. We worship Gurudev. We chant Guru Mantra, we chant the Gayatri, Anik. We must serve Gurudeva. By the mercy of this Gurudeva, then we can attain realization. Gurudev is so merciful. Śrīla Viṣṇu Chakravarti Pāda says, Gurudev is not an ordinary thing. Gu and Ru. Gu means what? Light. And Ru means? Darkness. Andhakar. So, Gu means light, Ru. Darkness means the one who gives love of Tatsiddhanta, manifests the light of love in our heart and of Tatsiddhanta. This is Guru Pada Padma Gurudev. Guru is actually, Guru also means very heavy. So one thing is Guru, heavy, another thing is Lagu, means light. Right? So something very light. So Guru is something very heavy.
Sadharan, Guru Pada Padme, Saran Lili.
So if we take shelter of the feet of Guru, all the obstacles, miseries will be removed, go away. And if we take shelter at one point at the feet of Guru, we'll never have any other fear. Very carefully, we have to worship the feet of Guru.
Sabadhane bandho bhaire. Nartam Das Thakur Prem Bhakti Chandrika.
Nartam Das Thakur in Prem Bhakti Chandrika. He verifies Gurudev.
Akhar dikchen. Ki akhar dikchen. Bandho mohi sabadhano mote. Sabadhan.
So what is the meaning of sabadhan?
Hindi te akte kotha bole. Sabdhanata hati.
In Hindi they say, if you're careful, you avoid accidents, right? So, if you are riding the car, for example, if you are not riding the car, like driving carefully, maybe like you fall asleep in the behind the wheels, then you have a big accident, right? Like some car accident happened. And I couldn't understand exactly to explain what happened. But anyway, you have to be careful to avoid accidents. So this word sabadhan is also in the Guru. This song to the Guru. You have to worship Guru with, like, carefully, you know, very carefully. Be careful not to commit offenses, all my brothers, sisters, all my friends. You have to worship the feet of Guru so much carefully, like, be careful not to commit offenses, otherwise finished. To the mercy of Gurupada Padma. If we get this, his mercy, then we have a, will not have any fear. His feet gives, removes all the fear. Abhay Charan Kamal. We have to take shelter of him. And only by his mercy, everything is possible. Paranguru Maharaj told in one lecture, he told, I don't know the mercy of Radharani. I don't know the mercy of Krishna as well. I also don't know the mercy of Mahaprabhu. I only know one mercy, the mercy of my Guru Pada Padma. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Srila Saraswati Prabhupada. This is what told Srila Bhakti Paragyana Keshava Goswami Maharaj. He told this. In one lecture, he told this. So this shows his Guru Nishtha, right? So we must know previous acharyas. Everyone wants to become the servant of Srimati Radhika. We want to become the servant of Srimati Radhika. Sorry. Our only mercy is to get the mercy of Srimati Radhika and to become her servant. This is true. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains in the kirtan. If we don't have the mercy of Gopinath, we cannot attain this highest goal. Aracharya say, you have to attain the mercy of Gopinath. But for that, we must first go to Govinda Dev. If we don't have the mercy of Govinda Dev, never ever will be able to get the mercy of Gopinath. But to get the mercy of Govinda, you have to go to Madan Mohan. You have to go to Madan Mohan. If you haven't gotten the mercy of Madan Mohan, you cannot get the mercy of Govindadev. And if you don't have the mercy of Govindadev, you will not get the mercy of Gopinath also. So in this way, our Gaudiya Vaishnavas, three deities are there. Govinda Gopinath and Madan Mohan. For the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, there are three main deities. Madan Mohan is the presiding deity of Sambandha. Govinda Deva is the presiding deity of Abhideya. Abhideya means what? All the rules you have to follow to attain to your goal. This is called Abhideya. Means bhakti. Abhideya tattva. And how to get bhakti? So, by bhakti, we can attain prema, right? So, Govinda Gopinath Madan Mohan. Madan Mohan is the Sambandha Adhishthati Devata, the presiding deity of the relationship with Lord. Govinda Dev, the Abhideya Adhishthati Devata, the presiding deity of the relationship. Sorry, Madan Mohan is presiding deity of the relationship we have with Krishna, Sambandha Adhishthatri Devata. And then Govinda Dev, presiding deity of the Abhideya, means process to attain to Lord. Abhideya Adhishthati Devata. And Gopinatha is the presiding deity of the goal, means Prayojana Adhishthati Devata.
Govinda Dev ke bola hoy Abhideya Adhishthatri Devata ar Gopinath ke bola hoy.
So Gopinath is the presiding deity of the Prayojan. Goal. Prayojan Adhishthatri Devata. What is our goal? So we want Krishna Prem.
এই আর যে বলুন উনি খুব ভালো বললেন এই জগতে আমরা কি চাই.
So what do we want in this world?
যাহা চাই তা ভুল করে চাই.
What do we really want?
Like,
we want what? Money, wealth, material things. But it's very difficult to get this. And if we get, we suffer so much. All these material things, family also, wealth, all this is giving distress, nothing else, cause of distress. Should I tell you the truth or not? So if you're not married, you think, oh, if I get married, I'll get a beautiful wife, I'll be happy, right? Then you get a wife. Those who are like women, they're thinking, I want to get a nice husband. So you get married, but are you happy in your family life? No. No happiness in the family life. So you're not getting what you really want. This is true. All the material things, they are only giving distress. Everything in this world gives us distress. But if you get Krishna Prem, then our life will be blessed. To get Krishna Prem, like for example, you heard about Rupa Sanatan. They were the prime minister and the financial minister of King Hussein Saha. Sanatana Goswami, he was the prime minister of the King Hussein Saha. He had so much wealth. Name, fame, reputation, everything. And Rupa Goswami, he was the financial minister, nothing less. But they gave up everything and they came to Vrindavan. Why? Why they came to Vrindavan? And crying and like in Vrindavan, crying for Shrimati Radhika, everything in Vrindavan.
वशांत विधि सबतो ब्रजपुरे खेदरी महाव्यालो बंदे रूप सनातनो रघुजीवो जीव गोपाल को हमारे स्वर्ग समीप कर ये
बोल आर सिक्स गोस्वामीज
सामान्य चलन ना
They were not ordinary people. They were actually born in high families. Panditas, they had all knowledge, everything. Santana Goswami was so clever, like so intelligent, so learned and scholarly. They had all money, you know. He was the prime minister. He had a lot of money. So much opulence. But he gave up all of this. And he was doing what in Vrindavan? I'm about to finish my class. Okay, but I want to tell one story. There was a devotee of Lord Shiva. So for many days, he was doing the worship of Shiva. For many days, he didn't ask anything for anything. He didn't want anything. But he had one daughter. And the time came for the marriage of his daughter, wedding of his daughter. Then he told Shiva, give me some money. Shiva told. But I don't have money, Shiva told. Shiva is, you know, wearing the tiger skin. He has no money, no cloth, nothing. He doesn't have anything. Oh, I have a friend. Where? In Vrindavan. On the banks of the Jamuna. He's staying there. He has someone, his name is Sanatana Goswami. So the Brahmana went there and he inquired, who is Sanatana Goswami? People told, oh, yes, near Madan Mohan Gera, there is one person, a saint called Sanatana Goswami. So the Brahmana asked and they told who was Sanatana Goswami. So the Brahmana came to Sanatana and told Shivaji sent me, so give me some money, I need some money for the wedding of my daughter. Sanatana Goswami told, okay, go. There's a dustbin in the banks of the Jamuna. Where there is a lot of dirt and dirty things and garbage, you'll find a touchstone there, you know, touchstone. So if you touch in the stone, even the iron will become gold. If you touch the stone in the iron becomes gold, okay? So the Brahmana went to the dustbin, very dirty. He saw, yeah, a touchstone was there. He's thinking, this is true or not? So he touched the iron and immediately the iron became gold, really. He became like, wow, amazing. Then he thought, then he was thinking, oh, I have so much iron in my house, I'll transform everything in gold and I'll make a very nice wedding for my daughter. I'll get kilos and kilos of gold and I'll make a very beautiful wedding for my daughter. On the way, he got the mercy actually of Shiva. So that's why the Brahmana started to think in the middle. Santana Goswami got this very rare jewel, which is the touchstone, which is rare even for great kings. He left this stone and he's wearing this loincloth, putting tilak on his forehead, taking the japamala in his hand. For which wealth he's trying, like which wealth he's trying to attain by his practice. Actually, Shiva is our guru. And you see, this Brahmana had gotten this mercy of Shiva, the Guru. Shiva is not ordinary. So Sanatana Goswami came back and told, for which wealth you are trying to attain, that you even gave up this jewel which is rare for so many kings and now you're here chanting some name. The Santana Goswami told, yeah, you got this sparsha money that if you touch the iron it will be turned into gold, but actually this will give so much distress, like a dacoits will come. Suppose if somebody know you have 1 or 2 kilos of gold, First of all, the government will also put the income tax and try to also take from you some. Also, dacoits will come, thieves. You know, they'll take or not. So this all gives so much distress.
Wealth is the perpetual source of distress.
So the wealth is the perpetual source of distress. You know, nothing else. So Sanatana Goswami told him this. So I want to get the wealth which is perpetual and only giving bliss. Which one? Krishna Premodhan. The wealth of love of Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told his mother. What people want in this world? They want to get wealth, they want to study and get good job, get wealth, but all this is actually giving distress. But Mahaprabhu told, I want that prem, that love, that if we attain that, we never get any kind of distress anymore. Then, Santana Goswami told, actually, I'm doing this practice here to attain the Krishna Prema Dhan, wealth of the love of Krishna. Nartam Das Thakur told, when will I get the wealth for Krishna Prem? Oh, this is so beautiful, Katha. Yeah, I'm about to finish my Harikatha. So the Brahmana, what did he do? He also threw away that touchstone and said, please give me mercy. And Santana Goswami, yes, mercy, chant Hare Krishna. This Hare Krishna, Hare Nam.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hey, Nam.
If you chant Hare Krishna, holy names, you'll get everything. There's no difference between God and His holy names. Whatever you want, holy names will give you everything. So in this way, you must chant Hare Krishna, Hare Nam. Chanting holy names, you'll be able to attain Krishna Prem. This is what Mahaprabhu is giving as teaching to the jivas of this world. What do we have to do? We have to chant Hare Krishna. We have to chant Hare Nam. If we chant, all your desires will be fulfilled. So, why the saints, they leave the house and they come to here, to the temple, like that saints, they give up, even if they are learned and scholarly, like some saints, they had university, master degree, so many things, and still they leave their like lives and they come to the path of bhakti. Why the saints do that? Because they know that can never be happy with material things. The only happiness comes by the chanting of the holy names of Lord. So they are preaching this also. We can get happiness only by chanting holy names. So actually doesn't matter. You're married or renounced, but whatever you are, just chant Gauranga and Narottama Das Thakur. Always is praying for association. Whatever you are, in every position in your life, just continue and just chant Hare Krishna. Harinam will give you everything. Harinam will give you everything. So if you want money, you just, like, and if you get money, you just use it in the service of Lord. The Brahmachari who was speaking before, he spoke very nicely, something that also Shri Narayana Goswami Maharaj Gurudeva used to say. That Yudhishthira Maharaj, Krishna told one day to Yudhishthira, you ask for some benediction. Then Yudhishthira said, I don't want anything. Oh, no? Okay. Then he said, oh, actually, Prabhu, yes, I want everything. I want wealth. I want a beautiful wife. I want sons. I want everything. Why? To use it in your service. So there's a Tyagi Marga, renounced path, and renunciation path, and Bhakti Marga. It's different. So the Tyagis renounce, they're saying, give up, give up, give up. But we say, don't give up. We say, Joro means connect, unite everything. Use everything for the service of Guru Krishna. So if you give up, then what? If God gave you wealth, money, just use this money for to the service of Guru and Vaishnavas, isn't it? If God gave you money, so use this money in the service of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. This good or not? Otherwise, just like Mayavadis, denying everything. No, 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 no. No, it's not about denying anything. No. Not about denying. Just use everything in the service of God. If God gave you some wealth, just use it in the service of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Make a beautiful temple. Build a beautiful temple. Then all devotees can come to the temple. They can take prasad. So you also get benefits. And those who get prasadam in the temple also, they will get benefit, right? Guru Vaishnavas will come. And you can serve Guru Vaishnava, so... So you'll also be very happy. Actually, I don't stay so much in Bengal. Generally, I stay out of India or in the North India. I don't come here so much. But I've been here for 15 days. And I have been associating with Shripad Govinda Maharaj, and I'm so happy to listen from him. Shripad Govinda Maharaj, Shila Bhaktivedanta Govinda Maharaj. He's speaking such a beautiful Harikatha. His character is so beautiful, funny, and also full of Tata Siddhanta. Not only a funny Harikatha that attracts the people, but actually full of Tata Siddhanta also, his Harikatha. So actually this Harikatha I'm hearing from home, from Shila Govinda Maharaj. I also glorify him. That's why the mercy of Govinda, mercy of Govinda. This is true, the mercy of Govinda. We have to get this mercy of Govinda. Without the mercy of Govinda, we can never get the mercy of Gopinath. So I pray that I can get this mercy of Govinda. Jai Govinda Dev Ki Jai Sri Radhe. Shripad Govinda Maharaj is exactly this one who just took the mic, last one, after Gurudev spoke.